Hi everyone, good evening. Today we are here to learn another set of SASMO question, grade 4. Let's start with. So it says a diagram shows a square being divided into four rectangles. So let's divide it into, just see, these are the four rectangles and this is our square. So let's divide it into, give it some name. This length is A, this is B. So this will be suppose C, so C, C. This will be A then, this will be A then. And suppose I write here D, so all of them will be D. Okay, so this will be B and D, done. So if you consider this one, so it will be 2A plus 2C. If you consider this one, this will be 2A plus 2D. If you consider the third one, this will be 2B plus 2C. And the last one, this will be 2D plus 2B. 2D plus 2B. Add all of them. So you got how much? 4A plus 4B plus 4C plus 4D. See, everyone has two pairs. Okay. So now we got 4a plus 4b plus 4c plus 4d. This is given as how much? 32, right? Because perimeter is given, and perimeter is anything just side of sum of boundaries. So we got a plus b plus c plus d as how much? 8. Now you see a plus b is equal to c plus d. So we can write c plus d twice equal to 8. Why they are equal? Because it is given it is a square. So C plus D is how much? 4. So now we can find the side of the square as 4. So area will be how much? Just simple as that. 4 square centimeter square, which give you 16 centimeter square. This can be visualized also very well. Little practice you can visualize, and no need to do this much, and you can directly go to the solution. You can solve it by little visualization. Let's see this problem. Here it says the first figure has 8 white and 1 black. Okay, you assume this as white because due to color contrast. And this one is 10 white and 2 black. So we are not bothered about black ones. We are considering just white ones. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here 12 white ones. Okay. Now, which figure will there be 2014 white square? So what they are saying, TN, if you go by the AP formula, I'll tell why AP, because you can see the difference is constant. 8, 10, 12, 14. You can see the common difference is 2. So TN is how much? 2014. First term is how much? 8. You don't know which term. And D is how much? 2. So just subtract. So 2006 divided by 2 equal to n minus 1. So 1003 equal to n minus 1. So n is nothing but 1004. Very easily you can get to the solution. Just application of AP series. Let's go to next question. So here, this is alphabetic. In the following alphabetic, all the different letters stand for different digits. Find the four digit sum P. So see, if you take a look at the question, this is L and here this is L. Okay. And these two are zeros. Okay. So let's assume that L is 1. So let's assume that L is 1. Okay, one thing more you can see, L could be like any digits from 0 to 9. But you see, this is becoming something being added without being added to any number here, gives you two digit number. So when L can be any number from 0 to 9, let's assume L is 9, okay? So we assume L is 9. So M, P, this become 9, this become A, this become A, this become E, E, and here we have 9, okay? Little heat and trial and you can just easily crack this question. Now here is P, same letter P. Now what letters when we add, you can get 9. And here you have to get same letter. So you can think that A will be 5. So because 5 and 5 will give you 10, this will be 0 and then 9 will be 0 converting and P will be 1. So let's see. So P will be 1, then M here and then 9 here. And this is 5 and 5. So this gives 0. Here it is 9. So it's come 0, 1. So definitely now you can work it out. Then M will be something which is carryover, not carryover. So M will be 8. Right, so our P is 1009. So you can see 58 added to 951 give you how much? 1009. Little heat and trial method can help you to solve this problem. Right, so let's see this question. When any Betty and Cheryl eat out each other's either each other or each orders either beef or chicken. So there are 3 person, Amy, Betty, and Cherry. And they have a fixed menu, like they are going to order beef or they are going to order either chicken. So if Amy orders beef, Betty orders chicken. So one at a time, they cannot order both this. So Amy order beef, chicken. Now, either Amy or Cheryl orders beef, but not both. So Amy has ordered beef, so Cheryl will not order beef. You can make that conclusion. Now, Betty and Cheryl do not both order chicken. So since Betty has ordered chicken, so Cheryl will not order chicken. But you can see these two statements, you cannot be very clear. So who could have ordered beef yesterday? So you can definitely say that Betty has ordered chicken today because this is our plus marks. We have our right here. So definitely Betty would have ordered chicken today and he must have ordered beef yesterday because you can see then it will set with other conclusions. So this is just a simple questions of just a visualization, not very real mathematics. Now this is a very, very good question. Try to understand this. Every time this type of question is appearing. Alex has a box measuring 40 centimeter by 50 centimeter by 60 centimeter. He has a box like this. He wants to pack identical Rubik cubes of 6 centimeter into the box. This is the box which he is fitting. So we have to take individual, like how much will fit in each side, no? Then only you can work out how much will be the total number of this. So 40 divided by 6, so 6 at 36, something 6 point something something. So you order 6, we will take the whole number. Similarly, 50 divided by 6, so 8 point something something, so we take 8. And similarly, 60 divided by 6 give you 10. So just that, 8 plus 6, 8 into 6 times 10, because every side they will be arranging. So it will have 480 cubes. So 480 Rubik cubes can be maximum fit in through the box if you have a box wearing this dimension. So this is the method to work it out. Note it down, this is very, very important question. And every time I have seen this is appearing Maths Kangaroo, Maths IMO, and every good type of Olympiad, they are asking children this type of question. So this is the method. If you work, you don't have to count and you don't have to assume. So it is very, very easy then. Okay, so thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. If you like, please subscribe to my channel. Take care, everyone. Thank you.